In this chapter, we'll be discussing about EPF and PPF. So EPF stands for Employee Provident Fund. So once you get a job in any bank or any company, you must contribute at least 12% of your basic salary, a DA, and retention allowance towards what is known as EPF, Employee Provident Fund. Okay, your employer will also make a matching contribution. So they will also make 12% contribution. This is only for the organized sector, okay? So the more you save in EPF, you can it will be useful for you at the time of retirement. Okay, so at present EPF is offering around 8.7% interest, and this rate will be approved by the finance ministry. PPF is also a scheme of savings, but this is for the unorganized sector. Okay, so unorganized sector means where they don't have any organized setup like companies who make matching contribution and all this stuff. So this is a scheme come up by the government to provide income security for self-employed individuals and workers from the unorganized sector. And the contribution you make will be deductible under Section 80C, so your tax burden will reduce. So both EPF and PPF are long-term investments, because at the time of retirement, this will be very useful for you. Just by contributing every month while you're working during your employment days, every month if you contribute some amount, it will build up to a huge amount by the time you retire, and it will give you financial security in old age. So one interview question that is commonly asked is the difference between EPF and PPF. So PPF is targeted for self-employed individuals and workers from unorganized sector, where we don't have this concept of employees contributing 12% and employer giving matching 12%. Okay, this is for the unorganized sector. EPF on the other hand is for salaried employees. You have to be more aware of EPF because banks come under the organized sector. So remember, EPF is a fund to which both the employee and employer will contribute 12%. This percentage is set by the government. So 12% of the employee's basic salary will be contributed every month. And at the end of every year, what the company will do is, this will be saved, this amount will be saved with what is known as EPFO. There is a Employee Provident Fund organization. This money will be not be kept with the company. This company will transfer the money to EPFO. And EPFO will manage your funds. Okay. And if required, you can withdraw EPF, so that amount accumulated can be withdrawn at the time of retirement or resignation. EPF is more beneficial than PPF, obviously, because the employer will also be making some contribution. And also EPF holder can withdraw amount if there is any personal emergency. Whereas in case of PPF, cannot withdraw till the completion of the tenure. But despite the advantages of EPF, PPF is the best option for people who don't have a salary, like people from the unorganized sector, because EPF is not available to them. And as I said, both EPF and PPF are eligible for 80C deduction, Income Tax Act. So one question you can expect here is, what is the maximum allowed deduction? Because just because your salary is high doesn't mean that you'll be allowed tax deduction for, say for example, you made contribution of 10 lakhs, EPF contribution. That doesn't mean you'll get tax exemption of 10 lakhs. So as per rules, the income tax deduction is available only up to 1 lakh. So in this chapter, the questions you need to prepare are, what is EPF? How much percentage of basic salary is contributed by the employee, that is 12%, by the employer, again matching contribution 12%. What is the rate of interest being offered on EPF? This keeps changing, but at the moment it's around 8.7%. What is the benefit of EPF to employees? So by contributing small amounts during their working period, it will build to a huge amount, and by the time of retirement it can be used for as a financial security in old age for their health benefits, you know, or other requirements. So can employee prematurely withdraw amount from EPF? Yes, they can. What is PPF? That is for the unorganized sector. What is the difference between EPF and PPF? Fundamental difference: EPF is for the salaried employees, organized sector. PPF is for the unorganized sector. Savings and EPF and PPF are eligible for tax deduction under which section? That is 80C. And what is the maximum exemption? 1 lakh.